Before we do that, someone hooked us up, so I'm going to have to play his jinglette first. Do you know what I mean? Bit of advertising for him. Free advert.
Breaking down on a motorway is never fun at the best of times, especially when it's cold, wet and windy and you have your whole family with you going on holiday. Government advice is to leave your vehicle and keep away from the carriageway and hard shoulder. The Rigloo High Visibility Shelter quickly inflates, creating a wind and waterproof environment for you and your loved ones as you wait assistance.
That's your car ready, guys.
Rigloo, the breakdown cover that really covers you.
There you go. That's Remy, who's hooked us up. Hey, good morning. Introduce yourself, my friend. Introduce yourself.
How you doing, all right? I'm Stuart Hay. I make comedy sketches based around football, more so based around Rangers and Celtic up here in Scotland. And that's what I do. You've probably seen my videos online. You've seen my videos on BBC. You see my videos in the paper because they go a bit wild.
I've watched a few, and they are, and that's why I said this morning, or I've said a few times, that some of your stuff is explicit, and a couple of listeners wrote in and went, don't clip his wings, don't clip his... And last week, because I'm really sorry, because I cocked it right up, because I'm waiting that's for right. you last Thursday in my... Look at this. All ready for you. Yeah, freedom and all that bollocks. You know what I mean, eh? I should have put the same George Cross on, but I've gone Union flag. You see, look at that, Great Britain and all that. Be proud.
Well, half my fans will love you, half my fans will hate you. There you go.
Fuck them, I'm not asked anyway. Fuck them. I never do anything for people to like me. I do things that make me happy. And it's like everything in life, isn't it? Some people will like you, some people won't like you. And there's no point trying to get everyone to like you because you've got no chance. So,
definitely. That's definitely
something
I've learned thick and fast.
Yeah. So, and the ones that don't like me, hey, come on, guys, let's have it right. We're all here for the same thing, anyway. So, what got you into comedy then?
Well, got me into comedy. It's just all something I've been interested in. I was a musician first. I've been playing in a lot of bands for a lot of years, and that just didn't work out. So, well, I joined. We need to try something else. And it was this, as you know, around about Glasgow, Glasgow, the west of Scotland, the football culture is very, very strong.
Yeah.
But it's just something like, I come from a mixed kind of crowd with my friends. A lot of my friends are Celtic fans, I'm a Rangers fan. And I just seen an opportunity for, like, just ripping the piss right out of it. There was a lot of things I seen that were my friends contradicting themselves, and then I seen a lot of Rangers supporters contradicting themselves. Well, a lot of things I've just thought about. There's something funny to be made here. I started it and it worked, and that's it.
So, for the benefit of people in Radio Land, and they can go and check it out later. So, do you do your sketches as a Rangers fan or as a Celtic fan, or do you do both and set the pit? Because I've seen some videos. So, pardon?
I do both. No, you do both. I try and keep as unbiased as I possibly can, because there's no point in just being a big Rangers fan and doing them, because then I'm just going to, half the people I'm only going to watch it, and half the people I'm not doing this to be a Rangers fan. I'm not doing this to be to promote Rangers or anything like that at all. I very much put the boot in the Rangers anytime I can.
That makes sense.
Which doesn't work out too well for me when I go to the games, I'll tell you that.
There he is getting. No, I get.
That definitely happens.
It's right though, isn't it? Because if you're a comedian, you know, and you like we were saying before, you can't appeal to everyone. But you've got to be, if you're being funny, and or you've got a point that you're looking at something, then people should appreciate that, whatever side they're on, shouldn't they? Really, do you know what I mean? But.
Well, that's in theory and on paper.
I know. Well, you're always going to get assholes, aren't you? Do you know what I mean?
But you're trying to make fun of something that people find very, very serious. It changes it a lot. I mean, a lot, like you know, for yourself, like in Glasgow and in Scotland, things like that, like. Rangers and Celtic aren't just football teams. There's massive religion overtones in it. So
yes.
it's a people's way of life up here. So when I'm sitting written absolute shite out of them, they can get pretty offended at times. And I've been on the end of that a few times.
I can imagine, and you're right, it is, because I said to my wife that he was coming on, she went, oh, he'll be Catholic or Protestant, whatever, and that's, it's amazing that in, you know, where we are in England, it's not really not really a problem, is it?
So no, I mean, you guys don't see any of this. I don't I always say this to any of my English friends, or every time I go down to England, I start speaking to people. I remember I went to a Man United game, and I got a ticket for a Man United game, and the boy told me, he's like, "Here's my season ticket. You're in with the ultras." And I was like, "All right, this will be good. Right, this will be good." One of the most timid things I've ever seen in my life, and I was going like, I don't know if English supporters could hack. Being up here with Old Firm, it's a different world. Yeah. It really, really is. And it's something you need to experience to properly understand it.
Yeah, no, I get that. I do get it. I've never experienced it. I do get that rivalry and that because it's more passion than just a football game. It's not football at all. I mean, I'm not a big football fan, but I used to go and watch City and Man City and the Derby, and I was in the stands once, and there must have been some United fans in the City side, and United scored, and they jumped up. I could believe it. About three of them jumped up, but there wasn't much left of them.
that's quite a death sentence up here. You'd never find it. I mean, it's hard enough trying to get a Rangers fan to go to a Celtic pub. Never mind sitting with Celtic fans, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
No, doesn't work like that up here. Does not work like that.
Yeah, you've got to be careful.
Imagine the stuff I get myself into when I'm trying to make fun of that. You know?
Yeah, yeah, because I saw one. There's one that I've seen, and he's knocking on the door, and he's like, "Me son, just because they've not been beaten, you've been beaten for last, he's miserable, he's not come down, he's 34 or something." He's like, that tickled me, that. It really tickled me, that. It tickled me.
That's what happens. That's me just speaking the truth. Like, I like my friends here. I'm in my 30s. So all of my friends are obviously the same age as well, and they just act completely and utterly childish anytime Celtic lose. And I've been blocked half things. I've been ignored. I've not seen friends in... Well, nobody's seen friends in months, but I've been just completely wiped off, like, friends lists. simply because this was the big season for Celtic. The one that was going to change it all. And they didn't get it. Actually, I woke up this morning to find out Neil Lennon's been sacked, so I'll be busy after I come off this.
Oh, fantastic. Well, you have to tag us in that. And it's great to have you on. What I'm going to do, I'm going to play a track now from a band in Scotland. Yeah, Scottish band. Yeah, it's not Rod Stewart. Don't worry about that. It's it might be up your street.
I thought he was English.
I don't know. I freaking don't know where he is. Fucking from everywhere. I don't know. Who cares? It's a bit like when it's St. Patrick's Day in the States, isn't it? Everyone's fucking Irish.
Oh, everybody's Irish.
They're all fucking Irish. All Irish. Every one of them. Oh, top of the morning. Never even fucking been to one of them. Do you know what I mean? Probably about four generations back. Everyone's fucking Irish.
I know.
Yeah. Same as here, though, in the UK, in England. St. Patrick. You can't believe how many paddies there are. St. Patrick's Day. Everyone's going around in green.
I tell you, I was in America a couple of years ago, and I got stopped for my accent, and I got asked where I was from. I said I was from Scotland, and exactly what you're saying, they just automatically think that they are Scottish too. But it's like, oh, I'm like eighth generation Scottish, and I'm also Irish. I'm also German. And I was like, where were you born? I was born in New York. Well, you're American. It's as simple as that.
Yeah, right? I've got
nothing else.
I've done my DNA, and I think Sandra's done the thing. You know, the tracking your, and I have got some Scottish ancestry. But you know what I mean? I won't claim to be Scottish. I'm 3% Viking as well. And I mean, I'm all over that. I mean, 3% Viking. But there we go. Right, I'm going to play these. These are called the Petty Cassettes. I think they're from Glasgow as well. I'm not quite sure. See me Scottish accent. Hey, Petty Cassettes. You know them? Have you heard of them?
I have. No.
Oh, you're going to hear them now. Here we go.